स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं परिषद् वर्ग जेतारं नित्यानन्द गुरुं.
We have seven layers in our being. Maybe I'll give you just simple diagram. Is it seen properly? No, I think. Now I think okay. Yes. Somebody asked me yesterday, there was a question. Somebody, why are you using all these modern things? I told them, what is the wrong? Perfectly all right. If Buddha has made 10,000 people enlightened without flight, car and computer, laptop, and without any infrastructure, website, internet, when we have all these things, we should make at least 200,000 people enlightened, 2 lakh people enlightened. So what is the wrong in using? So let all this infrastructure be used to transmit the true science. It doesn't have to be used to transmit only the ideas which was in the head of the people who invented. See, just because somebody has invented this, it is not that you have to accept the ideology and lifestyle of the person who was invented. That is what we are doing. Not just taking the comforts and scientific great things from the West, taking their lifestyle also, idiotic. And you don't know, 66% of the Western countries, the not just America, even the other so-called developed countries, 66% are taking some form of psychiatric medicines. Now we don't understand where we are heading. 66 is not small percentage. Sometimes I really feel blessed, fortunate that I am born and brought up in Indian villages. I was born and brought up in Indian village. I never heard so many problems. Not that I heard and I did not have those problems. I never even heard of those problems. The sufferings and problems which the so-called developed country kids are facing, I never even heard about them. It is good sometimes. So nothing wrong in using all this infrastructure. Let it be used and the proper ideas be spread. Otherwise, what we will do, we will start thinking the person who created this infrastructure, these discoveries, he knows everything about life. That is the foolishness. That is the foolishness. They may know how to operate all these machineries, but that does not mean they know how to live the life. In the East, we have done more than 10,000 years of research and development in the inner science, in the inner field, and let the inner science be spread using the machineries and infrastructures of the outer science. We have seven layers in our body. First layer, I'm just trying to give you a visual idea. Of course, surely not our bodies are like a round shape unless you are really obese. Even then it won't be exactly this circle. I'm just trying to give you a picture, an idea. First layer is the physical body which you are carrying, made out of flesh and blood. The second layer is the pranic movement, the prana movement which is happening in your system, like inhaling, the prana which stays inside you, and the prana which spreads all over the body, and exhaling and cleaning. There are five pranas: prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. The five pranas. The pancha pranas: pran, udan, vyan, saman, apan. The pancha pranas, all these movements are called prana sarira. And the next, the inner chattering which is going on in you, it's called mana, manasarira. the mind. The fourth layer is the emotion. I can say intense inner chattering which does not respond to your logical analysis. That is what we call emotions. That is the fourth layer. And the fifth layer is which you experience in the deep sleep. And the sixth layer you will experience in a strong meditation technique, means thoughtless awareness. The seventh layer is enlightenment. You have seven different layers in your system. If all seven different layers fall in tune with each other, suddenly you will see all the samskaras will leave your system. If the samskaras are taken out of your system, suddenly you will see all these seven layers fall in tune with each other. Balancing, reconnecting, reuniting starts happening. That uniting is what is called yoga. Beautifully Patanjali describes yoga chitta vritti nirodha, means living without samskaras. Only then the thoughtless state will be there. When the samskaras are taken out, the uniting happens. If uniting happens, samskaras leave your system. Physical, second prana, third mind, fourth emotions, fifth deep sleep, the karana sharira, the silence which you enjoy in the deep sleep. Sixth, the joy, bliss you enjoy in the thoughtless awareness, what Krishnamurti, Jaya Krishnamurti calls as choiceless awareness. And ultimate, the seventh layer, pure enlightened consciousness. Understand, uniting all these seven layers, removing the samskaras which you collected and stored. You store the samskaras in different layers. Yesterday somebody wrote me a question, Swamiji, this stuff was too strong for me, especially the analysis on the four states of consciousness. Mainly the answer for that question, that one question, when I come back I see the same world. Actually that person wrote a question in a very funny way. When I come back I see the same house, same car, same wife. He underlined that word. That word was underlined. I didn't. Same wife and same life. But when I go back to the dream, I don't see the same thing. Answer for that question was very shocking to him. I think the same person again wrote one more slip. During the darshan, I got the slip. He says it was too strong. I didn't expect I will have such a clarity. I am afraid of the clarity now. Understand, many times people are afraid of getting near the truth. Getting near the truth.